Once upon a time there was a kingdom named Pajajaran. The kingdom was ruled by Prabhu Siluangi. Prabhu Siluangi had three sons and one daughter from two empresses. From the first married he had two sons, they were Banyak Khatro and Banyak Ngampar. But when they were young their mother had died, and Prabhu Siluangi decided to marry again with Dewi Kumudaningsa. But before it they made an agreement, if one day they had a son, their son must be a king in Pajajaran. Then Prabhu Siluangi and Dewi Kumudaningsa married and had a son and a daughter, they were Banyak Blabber and Dewi Pamungkas. One day Prabhu Siluangi held a meeting at his palace. My sons, I want both of you replace my leadership in Pajajaran. I am too old to be a king in this kingdom, said Prabhu Siluangi. But, dad, I'm not ready for this, I don't have enough science and I haven't married yet. I will marry if I meet a girl who has a face like my mom. So, daddy, let me leave Pajajaran to find out a girl who I want. Replied Banyak Khatro. Well, Banyak Khatro, if that's what do you want, Banyak Khatro went to Tankuban Parahu Mount to meet a priest. He was Kayajar Winarong. He was a sacred priest, he knew how to get a girl who Banyak Khatro want, but there were several requirements that must be done by Banyak Khatro. He must departed from his greatness clothes of Pajajaran, and only wore an ordinal clothes, and he should be replace his name became Raiden Kamandaka. After several days he arrived at Kadipatan Pasar Luhar and met Padareksan Odo, and he took Kamandaka as his son. Kadipatan Pasar Luhar was led by Adipata Kandanoho. He had a daughter who hadn't married yet named Dewi Siptaroso. She had a face like Kamandaka's mother. Kadipatan Pasar Luhar has a tradition ceremony that holds every year. In this ceremony all family of Kadipatan followed to catch fish in Lagawa River. When Reksan Odo followed this ceremony, secretly Kamandaka had followed him. At this time Kamandaka met Dewi Siptaroso, and they fell in love. Raiden Kamandaka, will you meet me at Kaputran Park? Asked Dewi Siptaroso. Of course, Dewi. In the evening secretly Kamandaka went to Kaputran Park to meet her. He told about himself more clearly to Dewi Siptaroso. But then, the soldiers saw Raiden Kamandaka. Hey, who are you? Shouted the soldiers. Oh, no. Raiden Kamandaka, you have to go. Said Dewi Siptaroso. After that, Padareksan Odo called by Adipata. Padareksan Odo, is Kamandaka your son? I hear it from my soldiers. Asked Adipata. Sure, my majesty replied him. Oh. So, bring your son to me immediately, now. But, what happened so that you ordered me to do it, my majesty? Just do what I tell you, Pada. The soldiers chased Kamandaka and surrounded him until they came to a river. Kamandaka couldn't run away from them, so he was diving along the river. Adipata Kandandoho thought that he had died. Then Raiden Kamandaka met a man, he was Rikahaya, and they were be a best friend. Then Raiden Kamandaka stayed at Panaga village. Raiden Kamandaka be a fan of cockfighting. Fortunately Mbok Reksan Odo has a rooster, it's named Merku. In every match Raiden Kamandaka always be the winner, so he became very famous with his chicken. It was heard until Pasar Luhar, because of hearing it Adipata Kandandoho was very angry, he command his soldiers to catch Kamandaka. Suddenly a handsome man came, he admitted that his name was Siluwarni who will devote himself for Pasar Luhar. So he got a command from Adipata, he must kill Raiden Kamandaka, and to prove it, he must bring Raiden Kamandaka's blood and liver. Actually Siluwarni only a pseudonym name, his real name was Banyak Ngampar, the younger brother of Kamandaka. He was asked by his father to found out his sibling who had gone for a long time, to overcome any problem in the trip he provided Kujang Pamungkas Karas as a weapon. Then he went to Karang Lua's village, and at this village he met Raiden Kamandaka, but both of them didn't know each other. Then cockfighting between Kamandaka and Siluwarni happened. Suddenly Siluwarni stabbed Kamandaka by Kujang Pamungkas Karas, but it wasn't in his purpose. Raiden Kamandaka kept run until he arrived at a cave. He took a rest and hid from pursuit of Siluwarni in that cave. Siluwarni challenged Kamandaka from mouth of the cave. After hearing that challenge Kamandaka replied and told his identity that he was son of Pajajaran Banyak Khatro. Then Siluwarni told his identity too that he was son of Pajajaran too. So the name of Jatijajar cave is the second version of that cave. Then both of them forgive each other. But because he must bring Kamandaka's blood and liver, so he killed the dog and took its blood and liver. He said that it was Kamandaka. Then Kamandaka meditated in that cave, and he get a clue his dream to get married with Dewi Siptaroso will come true if he can get looting's clothes. The hobby of Adipata is hunting. One day he and his family hunt, they met a large and tame monkey that actually it was Raiden Kamandaka. But when they want to brought it home suddenly Rikahaya came and claimed that it was his monkey. He said that he wanted to help kept the monkey in Kadipatan. After arrived at Kadipatan, all girl wanted to kept the monkey, but during at Kadipatan it didn't want to eat, it only want received food from Dewi Siptoroso, so the monkey was kept by Dewi Siptoroso. In the evening that monkey changed into Kamandaka, and during the day it turned back into monkey, only Dewi Siptoroso who knew about it. One day, King of Nusakambangan, Pul Bahas wanted Dewi Siptoroso to be his wife, and if she refused he will destroy Kadipatan Pasir Luhur. Looting Kasaring, Kamandaka, suggest to accept Pul Bahas proposal, but there was a requirement during the wedding Dewi Siptoroso must be accompanied by Looting Kasaring. When the wedding took place Pul Bahas always disturbed by Looting Kasaring it, Mady was very angry, and they were fighting. Because of his supernatural power Looting Kasaring could be the winner, after King Pul Bahas had died Looting Kasaring immediately turned back into Raiden Kamandaka. Finally, Raiden Kamandaka married with Dewi Siptoroso. But because Raiden Kamandaka had defect in cockfighting with Sulawarni so he couldn't be a king in Pajajaran, and he only be a Dipita in Pasir Luhur replace his father-in-law, while the king in Pajajaran was Banya.